next class we will discuss about the 9th standard English lesson, The Enchanted Wood. So to relate this lesson, so before class, we have learned something about this lesson. So before going to this chapter, so before going to this class, so we have little bit glance what we have learned in the before classes. So we know this Enchanted Wood, this lesson was written by C. Rajagopalachari. So he was taken this lesson from Mahabharata incident. So when the Pandavas to lost their kingdom from the dice game, they are staying in the forest. So in the 12th year, so they are one day they are searching for deer, they are walk all over the forest, but they cannot get the deer, but they become a full of thirst. In that time, they want the water for drinking to quench the thirst, to satisfy their. That's why they want the water. So, in that time, in the same time, Yudhishthira will be sit under the one of the tree to take a rest. All his brothers are sit there. And also, Yudhishthira tell to one of his brother, Nakula, Nakula, you climb the tree, watch your surrounding, if there is water is available. So Nakula climbed the tree, he was identified what place the water. And also, he take the quiver. Quiver means we know case of arrows. So he take that one, he go to bring the water. So we go to there. So when he, before taking the water for his brothers, first he full of thirst is there. That's why he drink the water. He put his hand. In the same time, he heard one of the voice. Stop Nakula, don't drink the water. This pool belongs to me. I ask some questions. You answer correctly means then you get the water. But Nakula is ignored that, he can't listen that. Means he put his water, immediately he fell down. He go to near the death. Unconscious. So what he cannot come back. Once again, another brother, Yudhishthira sent to another brother, Sahadeva. So what happened to Nakula? You see and come. So Sahadeva also go there, is also same process will be going on. The unknown voice will be asked the questions. He can't also ignore that one. He also tried to drink the water. He also fell down. So again, Yudhishthira sent another brother, Arjuna. You go, Arjuna, see what happened. The both Nakula and Sahadeva. So Arjuna went there, he saw the both his brothers will be fell down. He was full of angry about who made this event. He shouted, but no one can respond there. In that time also, he was trying to, what means, I revenge against them. I take the revenge against them. But in that time, he can't able. Because he is a villain, he can't to do properly anything. He can't have, because he is full of thrust, monstrous thrust, very thrust is there. First he drink the water. So what happened in next, we see in this class. So this is the second class of this lesson. So now I read the lesson, listen carefully. So all of you open your textbooks, listen carefully and also see your textbooks. Again, the warning voice was heard. Answer my questions before you drink the water. This pool is mine. If you obey, disobey me, you are all follow your brothers. Arjuna became very angry. He cried, "Who are you? Come and stand up to me and I will kill you." He shot sharp arrows in the direction of the voice. The invisible being laughed in scorn and said, "Your arrows cannot touch me." Arjuna wanted to destroy this unseen foe, but first he had to quench his terrible thirst. So he drank the water and also fell down, died. After another anxious wait, Yudhishthira turned to Bhima. Dear brother, even Arjuna, the great hero, has not returned. Something terrible must have happened to our brothers. Please find them quickly. Bhima hurried away without another word. Like Arjuna, Bhima also did not heed the warning and drank the water eagerly, glaring around in defiance. Instantly, his great strength seemed to slip from him like a garment, and he also felt dead among his brothers. Puzzled and worried that his brothers had not returned, Yudhishthira himself proceeded in the direction of his brothers had taken. When he came near a pool, he saw his four brothers laying on the ground, to all appearance dead. He was shocked. He got into the pool to quench his thirst. At once, a voice without form warned him, "Your brothers died because they did not heed my words. Do not follow them. Answer my questions first and then quench your thirst. This pool is mine." Yudhishthira knew that voice, that these could be none other than the words of a yaksha, and guessed what had happened to his brothers. He saw a possible way of redeeming the situation. He said to the bodiless voice, "Please ask your questions." The voice put questions rapidly, one after another. So today we stop here. Remaining continue in the next class. Sure. So once again I read, you listen carefully and watch your textbooks. Again the warning voice was heard, "Answer my questions. Before you drink the water, this pool is mine. If you disobey me, you will follow your brothers." Arjuna became very angry. He cried, "Who are you? Come and stand up to me and I will kill you." He shot sharp arrows in the direction of the voice. The invisible being laughed in scorn and said, "Your arrows cannot touch me." Arjuna wanted to destroy this unseen foe, but first he had to quench his terrible thirst. So he drank the water and also fell down, died. After another anxious wait, Yudhishthira turned to Bhima. "Dear brother, even Arjuna, the great hero, has not returned. Something terrible must have happened to our brothers. Please find them quickly." Bhima hurried away without another word. Like Arjuna, Bhima also did not heed the warning and drank the water eagerly, glaring around in defiance, and instantly his great strength seemed to slip from him like a garment, and he also fell dead among his brothers. Puzzled and worried that his brothers had not returned, Yudhishthira himself proceeded in the direction his brothers had taken. When he came near a pool, he saw his four brothers laying on the ground, to all appearance dead. He was shocked. He got into the pool to quench his thirst. At once, a voice without form warned him, "Your brothers died because they did not heed my words. Do not follow them. Answer my questions first and..." and then quench your thirst. This pool is mine. Yudhishthira knew that these could be none other than the words of a yaksha and guessed what had happened to his brothers. He saw a possible way of redeeming the situation. He said to the bodiless voice, "Please ask your questions." The voice put questions rapidly, one after another. So this much of enough. I explained now the this much of lesson. So before going to explanation, we will see some of the words of their meanings. See, anxious. Anxious means worry, worry. Sure. So do think something bad. So suppose there are some people will be coming here. They are not coming. So we are waiting very anxiously, very worried about them. Sure. So we are waiting, waiting, waiting means our. So why they are not come? Why they are not come? Such a thinking is bad. Then we are thinking about that one. Sure. So that's why we are anxious. So next one, defiance. One refusal away somebody or something. So some people to telling anything, we are opposed that one. Sure. So we are refuse that one. So we can't accept that one. That is here.
Brother to fell down, go to near the death. You also face the same situation.
ಸೊ ನನ್ನ ಮಾತು ಕೇಳಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಇದಲ್ವಾ ಡೆತ್ ಹೋಗಿದಾರಲ್ವಾ ಸೇಮ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ನೀನು ಹೋಗ್ತೀಯಾ. ದಟ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹರ್ಡ್ ದ ಅರ್ಜುನ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಆಂಗ್ರಿ. ಆಂಗ್ರಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರವೋಕ್ ಗ್ರೂಫ್ ಕೋಪ. ಗ್ರೂಫ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರವೋಕ್ ಆಂಗ್ರಿ ನೋಡು. ಸೊ ಕೋಪ. ಸೊ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಆಂಗ್ರಿ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. Loudly was crying. What it means? Who are you? Come and stand up in front of me. Definitely, I will kill you. So Arjuna telling, hey, like only you say to voice. If you have courage means you come and stand in front of me. Definitely, I will kill you. Who are you? You tell. Ask the Arjuna, and also he take the immediately sharp arrow. He shoot the arrow in the direction of that voice. So in which direction he was discerned the voice, in that direction he was shoot the arrow. But in the time, another side, what the voice is there? That voice is laughing very loudly. Loudly, and it is telling. Means, negligible it is telling. What is it means? Your arrows cannot touch me, Arjuna. So you wanted to destroy me, it is not possible. Sure. So such a powerful person I am. Your arrows cannot touch me, cannot do anything to me. So that voice is telling like that, Arjuna. So in that time, Arjuna was telling, at any cost, I wanted to kill my enemy. I destroyed my enemy. For me, enemy. For means enemy. Enemy for first. But first what I did? So full of thrust is there. First I quench my thrust. I satisfy my thrust. So I satisfy my thrust means what I doing? I drink some water. That's why he go to near the pool to drink the water. So when he drink the water, he is also fell down like his brothers. He is also got to up to death. Achoda, such a situation will be arise unto the Arjuna also. So in that time, he is the another side. Yudhishthira waiting for the water. So anxiously was waiting. It means fearly, worry. So he was worry about that one waiting. Achoda, so long time was waiting. He was worry about that one. Tumba bejara agutte, tumba kova agutte. And also, he was tumba feeling also. Fearly, what happened to my brother? Such a feeling is there. Such a feeling he was waiting there. So and also finally he was called. Yes, another brother, Bhima. So Bhima, come here. Dear brother, even Arjuna also went there. So much of life is over. He cannot also come back. So he is a hero. Should have. So he is a one of the great hero. He is also not come back. He is one of the strength. Very strong person. So he is also not come back. What happened? I think your brothers to face some of the terrible problems, critical problems they are facing. Happened there, you go and see what happened. So in the same way, Arjuna to listen that voice, immediately he come there. He went near the pool to watch what happened there. So when he went there means he also saw all his three brothers fell down near the pool. So he is also full of thrust is there. So before doing any other thing means he quench his thrust. Quench means before that telling that one. Dhanivo tirskolo. Satisfy ourselves to drink the water. That is called the quench. So such a purpose he is also full of thrust is there. To want the water for drinking in that time. That's why he also go to try to drink the water. He also listen same voice. Sure. Same voice he was also listen. But in that time what happened? He is same voice is listen. Don't drink the water. You answer my questions. If you give the correct answers means you drink the water. But he is not he. Not he means not listen. He is also opposed, ignored. Ignored. Nirlaksha Martha. So he can't listen his voice. Leave it. So he is like, Bhima also ignored that one. So he is also trying to drink the water in the pool. So when he drank the water, he will drink that one. So he is one of the big person, very strong person among the in that time. Kauravas and both Pandavas, he is the strongest person. So when he drink that one, immediately what happens means, glaring around himself, anything he can't do in that time. So his complete body become a like a cloth. Means, so cloth is a weightless. So his body also become weightless. Immediately he fell down. So he is also going to near the death. So Bhima also not come back. So further time also Yudhishthira waiting there. All his brothers not returned. So he was thinking, so something happened there. So myself, I am went near the, what the problem, I searched there. So he is also go to what the direction his brothers went in the time. Same direction Yudhishthira also went there. So when he has go to near the pool, he saw all his four brothers laying down, their appearance the death. They are go to near the death. So they are becoming all are unconscious. They do not have any consciousness. Such a situation is there. So in the time, he is also shocked about that. But he can't bear for his thrust. So he is also quench his thrust. He is also becoming satisfaction his body to drinking the water. So immediately he tried to first drink the water. So in the same voice, before what the voice? Bhima, Arjuna, Sahadeva, Nakula, they have heard. Same voice heard the Yudhishthira also. So what means? Stop Yudhishthira. Stop. Don't drink the water. Suppose you disobey my voice, you drink the water. So what happened? Your brother would have died. You also face the same problem. Sure. So you have Thammadana Krishna Kalano, same. So then you drink the water. So first I ask the questions to you, then you give the answer correctly. Means then you quench your thirst. So that voice will be heard the Yudhishthira. So Yudhishthira one of the person, patience person. Because patience can listen that one. And also he is thinking his mind. What is going on here? Everything comes to his mind. So his voice is, he guess about the voice. So he is no. So he is none other than, he is a Yaksha. Yaksha means semi-divine being. So not a god, not a human being. So he is a god messenger. Sure. So that person, that's why he is some of the magicians. They are all. Sure. So they can't directly visible to others. They made some magic tricks. So such a person is called the Yaksha. So here also Yudhishthira guessed about that. So he is a Yaksha. Sure. And also he is thinking, what happened here? What the problem my brothers to face? So how to redeem that? Redeem means to make bad situation to better. So how to better do that one situation? How do I correct that situation? He was thinking to his mind. And asked the Yaksha. So what the question you ask Yaksha, you ask for me, I will tell the answers. See, he is thinking. Only Yudhishthira was to have the patience and thinking more and more. He is an intelligent person. So among all, but all others very clever and very strongest. But intelligence, Yudhishthira. So Yudhishthira was thinking in that time, what situation will be going on? How do I react to make the better? In such a situation to make bad better in the situation. So as like finally tell the Yaksha. So Yaksha, you ask the questions. I give the answers to you. So finally, Yaksha was asked frequently. So one question, another question, frequently asked the some questions. So what that questions we have seen in the next class. Sure. So what the Yaksha asked the questions to the Yudhishthira, how the Yudhishthira to give the answers. how he was redeemed and get back that bad situation as a good. Sure. So how he made. So this is we learn in the next class. Shall I stop in here in this class? Sure. So this is your this lesson, second part of the lesson, the enchanted.